Hello and welcome back to the Gaming Guild. Alex here. Oh, sorry. With day 136 of 7 Days to Die. Last time we did the Wright Residence, we finished up tier 4 missions, but I just kind of had to wait for the next day, so just kind of tackled that. Okay, there we go. I'm excited to see what tier 5 locations are around here. There we go. Pretty decent landing. Lugen.
So, well, that didn't take long. Nice work.
So you forgot I was full of stuff. Sell those. And no, we're not gonna need that. Probably not gonna need a compound bow, but
let's hold on to it just in case. Good work.
29 and 29. Right, tier 5 jobs. We have an infested clear.
I would love
at the right residence.
Well, check back soon.
That one's north of us, though. And we have another infested clear east at Fort Quonset.
Yeah, if you could just go ahead and take a job.
Looks like our other ones are all pretty far away. Definitely outside of the wasteland. So it might just be that there's no tier 5 locations in the wasteland, which is too bad. But let's go ahead and do this infested clear.
Oh, thank goodness. I couldn't find anyone to do that job.
And then let's see. Let's buy all of these and buy that.
Thank you so much. Hey, come again.
Some stuff off really quick. There, eat the lamb. Let's have some coffee. Okay, let's see if either of my vehicles can take a supercharger. It'd be awesome if I could throw it into here. Okay, that's nice. That's gonna make things a lot faster. And I think 762 should be plenty. Yep. Okay, let's go get to a runway. Actually, I think this will be enough space. And we're going that way. Oh. Wow. Okay, yeah, the supercharger, I think, is what threw me off so much for that takeoff. I am hauling. I was worried that I was gonna, you know, cut out again and do my little bit of a skit, but I'm gonna be there in no time. This is pretty nice. Definitely get used to this. There's the drive-in theater, or the stage theater thing. I think we've been to this base before. Just to do an extra 11 damage to this. Okay. Okay. So, infested clear. So, this is a 7, tier 7 mission, technically. The 2 from the wasteland. Well, I definitely want to get to another blood moon here, but I have a feeling I'm gonna run out of things to do here in the wasteland. You know how there's not any actual tier 5 locations. And even if I did, you know, these escalated tier 4s or travel to do some tier 5 missions for Jen, there's never a tier 5 location here. We'll never get to the point where we can actually do a tier 6 location in the wasteland, which is our ultimate goal. That would make it a tier 8 job, just if you add the difficulty of it being the wasteland. Almost looks like it could have been a secret. Like, that would have been a fun little thing, just like, oh, there's a secret entrance in to here or something. You want another one? There's some trash down there. It could always be something good, but I don't know, I just feel like I'm wasting my time checking every trash pile. I'm definitely in favor of the mechanics of the game being so like you can have a stealth playthrough, but to some extent I feel like it's almost like too easy to be stealth at times and then too hard at other times. I know one of the hints for the game is like, oh, like throw a rock or a snowball to distract a zombie that's passing by. And it's like, okay, yeah, that's cool. You don't get experience for that, so it's not really worth your effort to be like that heavy in the stealth portion of the game. So that would be a cool feature if they could implement that somehow. Of just, you don't have to kill a zombie. To gain experience. And I know obviously there's other ways of gaining experience. But just like the sheer amount of experience you get for kills really makes you favor getting every single zombie kill you can. And you know, the quests to clear out an area, especially with the infested quests, you have to get all of them dealt with. But if there's just, yeah, some way to make it so that there's a reason to want to be as stealthy as possible, that would be pretty cool. Come on. Stormy. Okay. Let's drop that, drop that. Cloth. Also, I've seen so many soldier zombies and hazmat zombies, like, I need other zombie types for thumbnails for our videos.
Okay.
They're all dealt with. Ooh, there's a lot here. Silencer mod. I want to take that. Take all this. Okay. Ooh, some honey. If we're fast enough, we can get all the way back to Jen and see about taking another job. Cass. Sure, I'll take a battery. Never know if I need one for something. That's quality 5, so it's pretty good. Ooh. Quality 6 compound crossbow, that's good. Anything in here? Nope. Anything in here? Not really. Alright, let's get out of here. This takeoff is a little bit better. The supercharger actually makes takeoff a little bit harder. Like you think, oh, you'd build up speed faster and be able to just, no, get up into the air really quickly, but it actually keeps me from taking off too fast, or getting into the air too fast. I almost need more runway to make it work. I'm sure if I had like one of my like hospital takeoffs where I take off from the helipad at the top, it would be just fine because I'd just be up to speed and just glide off of it. Yeah, the supercharger definitely changes the way it behaves.
I didn't think you had it in you. Good job.
Ooh. Quality 6 impact driver. Let's take that. And then let's go ahead and take this right residence.
I had a good feeling about you. Good luck.
Anything to sell? Anything to buy? I think I had just regular cement that I could buy. And, oh, you probably have some slugs. Maybe? Yeah, there they are. Let's go ahead and buy those.
Remember me if you need medical supplies.
All right. Now that's another potential improvement, just to like the realism of the game. Make a lot of these goods. Like, sure, you could find some raw honey, maybe some just regular bandages, maybe a rare first aid bandage, but make first aid kits, make casts impossible to find. Just like, completely take them out of loot. You know, maybe advanced recipes for crafting, but really you have to go to Jen to buy first aid kits and casts. You have to go to Joel to buy special ammo. You have to go to Rekt. I think Rekt is the food guy. So you want to get like fancy meals or even buy fancy recipes. You have to buy them from him. To really kind of like bring in that, you know, we can only get so far on our own, that we really need to work with the traders. And you can even make it so that there's more trade items, like throw more silver and gold and gemstones into the loot piles and stuff. Other things that the traders will buy from us, but they're relatively useless. And then we, you know, yeah, get a lot of dukes, but then we're trading them back in. I know it's not like a real economy or anything. I kind of treat it as an economy in this game, and build off of that. And I just feel like there's more that could be done with that. That off. Water. This battery. I still have some ammo. Let's see. Yeah, an impact driver, and but before I just had a wrench. So this will help a lot. The only thing that I could really ask for right now would be an auger. Auger would be pretty cool. Let's go ahead, make another chest, just because I already have just so much ammo built up. Okay, throw it on this side. Let's take all of you, and all of you, and then. Everything reloaded. Yep. Things looking good. I could probably use a little bit of food. Shepherd's pie is a lot. Meat stew. That's a good one. Kind of just tops off everything for me. I'm a little surprised I don't have, like, screamers or anything. They always show up during a mission and never when I'm actually just, like, doing stuff in my base. Let's go to the road to take off. Just because the takeoffs have been a little weird. I think I just need more of a runway, not because I can't like get up to top speed fast enough for it to take off, but like the game almost needs a certain amount of time since I first hit forward before it allows me to start going up. And with a supercharger and me going faster, I just clear more distance before I'm allowed to start going up. The only thing I can really think of that's causing that to happen. I could see the game mechanic standpoint being that you need to be in the helicopter, the gyrocopter, just long enough to like build up speed with the not like actual movement speed, but the speed of the propellers spinning to get to the point where you can lift off from the ground. Have we been to this one? I think we have. Take that. Anyone else out there? Alright, well, it doesn't seem like there's too much around here. We did clear it out before, so that's... No. Oh. Zombies are back, though. But there's not really any point, because they're all just going to respawn anyways. Could do a quick book check. Actually, I could do a really quick book check. Let's make one building block. This. Good morning. Let's do a quick book check, and then we'll call it a day and start this mission tomorrow. Finished off sledgehammers, that's nice. That's good. Well, that's gonna do it for today. Ooh. Once I'm done with this. Now we'll call it a day. Thanks everyone for watching. I hope you had fun. And I'll see you all in the next adventure. Bye-bye.